O Mother of perpetual help, thou art the dispenser of all the goods which God grants to us, miserable sinners. And for this reason has he made thee so powerful, so rich, and so bountiful, that thou mayest help us in our misery. Thou art the advocate of the most wretched and abandoned sinners who have recourse to thee. Come, then, to my help, dearest mother, for I recommend myself to thee. In thy hands I place my eternal salvation, and to thee do I entrust my soul. Count me among thy most devoted servants. Take me under thy protection, and it is enough for me. For if thou protect me, dear mother, I fear nothing, not from my sins, because thou wilt obtain for me the pardon of them, nor from the devils, because thou art more powerful than all hell together, not even from Jesus, my judge himself, because by one prayer from thee he will be appeased. But one thing I fear, that in the hour of temptation I may neglect to call on thee and thus perish miserably. Obtain for me then the pardon of my sins, love for Jesus, final perseverance, and the grace always to have recourse to thee, O Mother of perpetual help. This is one of many prayers recited by Catholics all around the globe. O Mother of perpetual help. In this specific prayer, Mary intercedes for the believer, and Mary protects the believer from fear, sins, devils, judgment, and yes, Jesus. Mary protects the believer from the judge himself, Jesus. Why? Because God is appeased by the mediation of Mary. No true regenerated Christian can in good conscience recite such blasphemy. This is not Christian and should not be labeled as such. Hebrews 7:25 says, "Wherefore he is able also to save them to the uttermost that come unto God by him, seeing he ever liveth to maketh intercession for them." Romans chapter 8 verse 34 says, "Who is he that condemneth? It is Christ that died, yea, rather, that is risen again, who is even at the right hand of God, who also maketh intercession for us." Well, maybe it's this. Maybe Christ intercedes for us, but Mary helps in that mediation. Absolutely not. 1 Timothy 2:5 says, "For there is one God and one mediator between God and man, the man Christ Jesus." There is one God, and there is one mediator, and it is not Mary. It is the Lord Jesus Christ. This religion has dangerously deified Mary. Don't believe me? Well, let's think about this. The Catholic Church has attributed to Mary that which should be reserved only for God. And I don't believe that this is by an accident. This is a strategic attempt to rob God of His glory. Think about it. Jesus Christ is the Redeemer of the world. They call Mary the Redemptrix. Jesus Christ is the mediator between God and man. They call Mary the Mediatrix. Jesus is the King of Kings, and they call Mary the Queen of Heaven. There is no scriptural basis for these beliefs. This is religious tradition passed down from generation to generation, all because a pope decreed it, a council declared it, or a philosopher deemed it to be so. But doctrine should not be derived from a pope, a council, a philosopher. Divine doctrine comes only from the Word of God. Now, this particular Catholic belief of Mary stems from what is called the Marian Dogmas, or doctrines. There are four we will discuss in this video. Number one, divine motherhood. But first let me state that Mary was a wonderful woman. God chose her to give birth to the Messiah, and this is undebatable. With that, we would agree. Mary is even called the mother of Jesus in the Bible. There is no disputing that fact. But this doctrine goes beyond these basic fundamentals. Listen to how this doctrine is explained by Catholics. The divine motherhood is not only Mary's greatest privilege, but it is the key to the understanding of all her other privileges. Not only does this truth hold the primacy in Mariology, but it is so intimately connected with the whole economy of salvation in Christ that for the past 1,500 years, the recognition of Mary as Mother of God has been a touchstone of Christian orthodoxy. For if Mary is not truly the Mother of God, listen to this, then her Son, Christ our Redeemer, is not true God as well as true man. Moreover, His salvific work for the redemption of mankind would be nothing more than vapid imaginings of a restoration that had never taken place. This is very dangerous. Christ is not who He is because of Mary. Christ is who He is because of His perfect immutability. Mary was just a mere vessel used by God to give birth to Jesus. The character of God in flesh is not dependent upon the character of Mary. Here is the counterfeit. God is the Father of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and they say Mary is the mother of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the mother of God. Number two, Immaculate Conception. Here is where we go off the rails. This is how the Vatican explains it. The most blessed Virgin Mary, from the first moment of her conception, by a singular grace and privilege from Almighty God, and in view of the merits of Jesus Christ, was kept free of every stain of original sin. So basically they believe that in order for Mary to have conceived Jesus Christ in her womb, she had to be miraculously conceived herself so that she would be immune to original sin. This is not within a million miles of the Bible. Mary, as good of a woman as she was still a sinner in need of a Savior. This is another counterfeit. The Son of God was miraculously conceived, and they say Mary was miraculously conceived. Number three, perpetual virginity. The Vatican says the deepening of faith in the virginal motherhood led the Church to confess Mary's real and perpetual virginity even in the act of giving birth to the Son of God made man. In fact, Christ's birth did not diminish His mother's virginal integrity, but sanctified it. And so the liturgy of the Catholic Church celebrates Mary as the ever-virgin. This means that Mary was a virgin her entire life. Now, any student of the Bible knows this to be utter nonsense. Matthew chapter 1 says, "Then Joseph, being raised from sleep, did as the angel of the Lord had bidden him, and took unto him his wife, and knew her not till she had brought forth her firstborn son, and he called his name Jesus." This means they did not have a sexual relationship until after the birth of Christ. Luke chapter number 2 says, "And so it was that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered, and she brought forth her firstborn son." and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. Also, the Gospels, the Acts of the Apostles, the Epistles, they all affirm that Jesus did in fact have brothers and sisters. This is another counterfeit. Jesus never knew a woman, and they say Mary never knew a man. Number four, assumption. The Vatican says, taken up to heaven, she did not lay aside her salvific duty. By her maternal love, she cares for the brothers and sisters of her Son who still journey on earth. I believe with all my heart that Mary is in heaven. But let me be very clear. The only activity she is partaking in is the worship of God. She does not have any salvific duty. She is not interceding for you. She is worshiping the one true and living God. This is just another counterfeit. Christ ascended into heaven to intercede for us and to mediate and to be our advocate. And they say Mary is assumed in heaven with certain operational duties. This is not Christian. Christians pray only to God through Jesus Christ. Christians worship God and Him alone. And Christians believe the Word of God. Friends, Catholic Mariology is dangerous doctrine.